Okay, everybody, we are having issues with the trolling motor. So after, what, less than a year, I think we picked this girl up in February this year, 2020. Here we are in December, 10 months later. This plug right here is very loose where the trolling motor goes into the kayak. So we have to pull a battery box up here. And then what I learned was that it's actually this plug. So this plug is loose right there. We're gonna have to replace it very soon because it's moving around. And because it moves around, I kept jiggling this cord, which I'm not even gonna touch right now, because one of the terminals has already backed its way out. So I had to push that little nipple back in, brought the battery forward to connect to this. The main reason why I did that was because I didn't want that little nipple falling off inside here, inside the plug itself. So if it's gonna fall off, it'll be right here. When I pull it apart, it's exposed. I can still pull it out and put it back here. Once the trip is over with, if I can remember, I will show y'all the issues that I'm having with the wiring itself. And I'm gonna have to order a new part. I'm just not sure. We got the Christmas holidays ahead of us, so that is first and foremost as far as funding goes. So yeah, just thought I'd give y'all that little tidbit of what is going on with the kayak and what y'all may experience in the future. I mean, I don't know. I definitely fish this thing hard, and it gets its use for sure. Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for clicking on today's video. Today I'm here with my man Beto. He's got a YouTube channel, Innovation Fishing, right?
That's correct.
First episode ever on his channel. Be sure you're going to go over there to check that out. His channel, I'm saying channel a lot, it will be linked in the description down below. So I highly recommend going over there, helping my man out. He's been a big supporter of my channel, and whenever I can give back, I will. Today, it finds us in a marsh system that we have not hit in quite some time. So we'll get out there, see if we can toss around a few paddle tails, and at least I'm gonna do that, with some bugs. Hopefully we'll be able to get into a good trout bite. Yesterday was exceptional because we were able to find some of the fat girls swimming in another marsh. So trying to pick and choose our spots, seeing where they're gonna be hiding. If you're a patron, stay tuned because hopefully we're gonna bring you a great fishing report. All right, let's get started. I'm gonna load this fella up with some ProCure. Y'all saw me do that in the last video. There's got to be a simpler way. Someone told me about a syringe for the ProCure that you can kind of help yourself load this stuff in there. So we're gonna check that out on Amazon and see if we can link that down below so that you all can take advantage of this as well. A lot of people like to use Gulp, and I'm not gonna down talk that stuff. It does work, but that Gulp juice, if you've ever used it before, you know it gets everywhere. And that's the only reason why I try not to use it anymore. ProCure works really well. It gets everywhere, but it's not gonna get everywhere in your tackle tray. So that's why I go to that. I use this ProCure. What the? Oh yeah, I forgot. There is no battery down there. I was like, why are these tackle boxes freaking falling? Okay, fellas. That's gonna spook a redfish. I'm telling you what, we gotta get our life together. Look at these seagulls coming down. Let's try and see what it is that they're going after. I mean, I left the bank and started casting right out here in the open. Let that lure fall. All right, I'm just gonna let that fall to the bottom. Maybe we get lucky, pick up a speckled trout. Maybe we don't. This is speckled trout weather right now though. Ah, little shrimp. That's what they're diving down on. Right there. I see the bait. You can kind of see that ripple going against the wind. Got him! So the shrimp are being pushed up by these little trout. Thank you, Mr. Seagulls. Just gonna spot lock it really quick. Cut the motor. Spot lock ourselves. All right. Look at that. Crushed it. Nice. Isn't that gorgeous? See you later, little buddy. Strong outgoing tide. Right here is the bait. You can see that. It's cast. Let's see if we can get something. Uh-oh. I'm just letting it drop. Little cookie cutter. If you have little ones that love to go fishing with you, this right here will keep them occupied for hours coming out here and being able to hook into these guys. There we go. Paddle tail coming in clutch. Another cookie cutter speckled trout. Needs to fatten up. Right there where they just went down, that's some more bait. All of it is shrimp, about an inch, inch and a half. And what they're doing is leaving the safety of the marsh, because during the winter time it does get, them north winds will drain our system. And those fish, I mean the fish, the bait cannot stay there. If it does, they're just gonna freeze and die, or they'll dehydrate. They will kill themselves if they stay behind too long. So they're migrating out into the bays and eventually the Gulf, taking refuge to like maybe warmer waters and stuff like that. So you got all this shrimp moving, and then with the tide, it just makes it easy for the specks to start coming chasing them. The birds, in turn, when they see that stuff going airborne, they kind of help to let us key in on where the fish are moving. Oh, we just got tagged right there. All right, here we go. We're gonna super slow, and we got him. He feels a little bit heavier. Let's see if he's gonna be our cookie cutter size. Ever been water skiing, buddy? A little bit bigger. Little bit bigger. By about 2 inches or so. All right, get inside the boat. Oh yeah, that is a good 12 incher right there. Nice hook set right on the side of the mouth. I'm gonna have to take these gloves off and just suffer through the cold, because it's pretty hard to put my hands, my fingers inside the forceps. But look at that. Okay, get him in the shade right there. Now y'all can probably see him. That is a good speckled trout. Man, oh man. I don't mind sitting here weeding through the little fellas, because if we move like towards the marsh, there's no guarantee that the reds are gonna be there. It's like a crapshoot. They could be there actively feeding. What we gotta do is wait for the sun to warm up the bank, and all that soft mud and oyster will start absorbing the heat from the sun, being that we do have it out today. And hopefully that's gonna attract the reds and trigger them to start feeding. But right now, under the birds, not bad at all. Got you. This guy feels a little bit bigger. Oh yeah, nice. You dummy. That is 14, so, no, 13, 14, somewhere around there. Hear a boat coming. Thank you. Gotta hurry up and get you off, buddy. There we go. Little shimmer swimmer. We're just weeding through all the little fellas. Yeah, that's a 13 incher. Nice healthy one. And let's get back to fishing. Alrighty everyone, I've got the ultimate skinny water hack for all you autopilot owners out there. I haven't told anyone about this with exception to Nick and a few of my other close YouTube friends who do own this kayak. Let's put the hat on really fast and I'll try to discuss this and explain it as best I possibly can being on the water, and we'll throw some B-roll shots later on. But in order to get super skinny, this autopilot goes down. Okay, this is your stow and deploy cord. We're gonna deploy it. Now, it's all the way locked down right now, and then you put it in the cleat. When you get into some of these marsh systems, for all of you skinny water freaks out there, whenever you get through some of this stuff, you're working in about 6 inches or less of water. This will get you through about 6 inches if you do what I did. Now, here we go. We're gonna stow it, or somewhat stow it. We're gonna raise it up and you can see how it's coming up. So check this out. Look what I can do, because I completely bypassed the kill switch. No kill switch here. There's another kill switch right up underneath here, but it's completely bypassed. So what I can do, turn my motor on and off, no matter what. There's no kill switch involved. It's gonna void your warranty if you bypass that kill switch by clipping the wires. What you can do is purchase a small little magnet, put that right up underneath here. That will engage the kill switch. You'll still need to use that one over there, and you're not gonna void your warranty. But the problem is you gotta find a magnet small enough that will fit right up underneath here. You can feel it. And as long as that magnet doesn't fall off into the water, then you're gonna be good. You can accomplish the same thing. So what I do is I deploy it. We turn the motor on. Now, I'm gonna slowly raise the motor until you start, you hear that? That's the prop hitting the hull. There we go. Now we lock it in place, and that prop is right up against the hull. Like, I'm talking inches, like not even inches, probably millimeters away from the hull. We're able to get into this skinny water, and you're gonna have the ultimate skinny water machine. So that is why I went away from the Hobie Outback, because with the Outback, it was the ultimate skinny water machine until enter the autopilot. With the Hobie, those fins have to be fluttered. And so that means you got to put your legs apart and then just do this motion. Look like a retard right there. So with the Hobie, you got to just like flutter. That's a horrible representation of what's actually going on. But when you flutter the fins, they're riding up against the hull. It uses a lot of leg energy and you get tired really fast. So when this came out and I figured out how to just bypass the kill switch by raising up the shaft, now you can get into that 6 inches of water with no issue. And then once you get shallower than that, then you just use the paddle to push pull. It is a game changer. It has allowed me to get into the marsh and scoot about in the skinniest of water, chase down them reds, and oh, voila. That right there is your ultimate skinny water hack for the autopilots. One of the other things that I forgot to mention about the hack is that whenever it's in hack mode, let's just call it that, you cannot control the motor. Like, I'm gonna turn it to the left, the head unit will turn to the left, and the kayak's not gonna respond because that little collar down there, it's like a half moon, it has to engage with the collar on the head unit to actually turn the shaft of the trolling motor. So some of y'all ask, why don't you use spot lock whenever you're in the marsh and you're catching these fish? Because spot lock won't work. It'll just keep twisting until it goes to like a default error mode, and then you gotta unplug the entire system and then plug it back in to reset it. So I don't use spot lock. I'll use my little stakeout pole that's 4 foot long straight through one of these scuppers, and that's what's gonna anchor me whenever I wanna spot lock in super shallow water. So spot lock does not work, steering does not work. What you do before you start raising it up, you put it in straight forward, and then you use your rudder controls with the foot pedals.
That's redfish one.
You think so?
Yeah, I just seen some tails.
Okay. Oh, that's a red over there, Bethel.
Yeah.
Come over here, brother.
Yeah, that one right there, right?
Oh, wait, you know. Yeah, it is a red. It is a red, bro. Holy cow, that's a big one, bro. Yeah, hurry up. That's got to be a red. Wait, I don't know if that's a red or not. It's a dying red. He's dying. I think he's belly up. Yeah. I was wondering, like, why is he just sitting still? Oh, that is a big red, bro. Goodness gracious. That poor fella's on his last leg. Man, oh man, that's the easiest catch of the day. Anything in his mouth? I almost wonder if a hawk got him. Does he got any marks on him or anything?
No.
Nothing, huh? Something probably, somebody probably hooked him and he's on his way out or something. I don't know.
Do I let him go?
Yeah, yeah, just let nature take its course. The crabs will get fed. Oh, right here. Oh my God. Where did he go? Oh, here he was right here. He just, that dude, with, here he goes over there. His wake taken off. Something spooked him. Like, here goes everything that he was making. So yeah, redfish, that was a big one, bro.
Big old red, huh?
Yeah, gosh. Something's waking on it. Got him. Oh gosh, I saw that wake just building up. I thought it was a duck at first. There was two of them in there. One went out, and then this dude right here stayed inside there. Oh, that is a donkey. Brother, we had to work for this guy. There was two of them in there, and I thought it was a stupid ducks. So this is the prime example of why I call them mud donkeys. I mean, this guy just pulled like crazy. But look at the mud he's got on his face, because we are in some shallow. I'm talking some very skinny stuff right now. Look at that. He's got a little bit of mud left. The net pretty much cleaned them off, but that is why we call them what we call them. Look at that gorgeous redfish. Brute tail, blue tail, brute tail, brute strength, blue tail. On the flats bug, we like downsized because we're in skinny water. The wind is not able to do its thing. Perfect hook set too, right in the top of the mouth. I saw you going for it, son. It gets so exciting whenever these guys do a big old huge wake coming after it. Gosh, it's a mid-slot donkey. Okay, got that one in. This is a pain. This is seriously a pain that nobody should have to go through. But this plug is just done. gosh, and it picked the fine time to go wrong because I'm trying to get out of this marsh system and I can't. All right, we're done. These little posts that are supposed to be right here, they've fallen off just through everyday use, and now they're stuck inside the battery. I'm gonna pull those off so that we don't mess up our battery in any way, shape, or form. And then we're gonna have to paddle our way back. But this is a bummer. Let's pick up the motor. Ain't no sense in having that down because it's not, I mean, we can't use it. So let's just get going. It's gonna be a long paddle back and this is gonna suck. Safety, yeah, there's safety in numbers for sure. Like if I came out here by myself, which I do a lot, then I would have had to end up paddling all the way back. It happened to me in Essex Bayou once. I got all the way back there and I didn't realize that I forgot to charge my dang trolling motor battery. I thought it was fully charged and it just kept it. The motor would start and then it would turn off, then it would start, then it would turn off, and I was like, what the heck is wrong with this thing? Like, it's moving, but then the minute that I put it above like 3 or 4, then it cuts off. Well, the battery was drained completely and I was like, I bet this battery is drained. And then
that's probably what it was.
Yeah, it was.
Exactly.
The battery completely drained and the nasty weather came in. I got rained on. Dude, it was, how far was it in there? I think it was just shy of 4 miles that I went all the way back into Essex.
God dang. How much did we do right now?
This right here has got to be, man, I don't know. We'd have to measure it. I'm going to say maybe, when it's all said and done, probably 10 miles.
Dang,
it doesn't seem like it because you're fishing along the way.
That's those mullet eating the line,
bro. Yeah. One of us is going to blind cast a darn red. I mean, I know they're out here. I mean, we saw that blow up over there. I saw the wake. Got him. Told you, bro. I told you. Go ahead and kill your motor. Oh, is that a trout? That is not a trout. Surely. He's shaking his head like a trout. That's a red, bro. There ain't no trout gonna do that. Yeah, it's a red. No, no. He's in the mouth. All right, right over here to Beto's side. You got that donkey. Look at that. You just can't get better service than that.
Right.
Beto comes to pick me up, save the day, trolling back. And look what we get. Donkey number 2. I told you we were gonna blind cast something, bro. Bro, let it go. There we go. He got my lure tangled inside that net. That is a nice sized donkey, barely, like barely 20, somewhere around there. Pushing a little bit over 20. Thank you so much for playing, my little fella. Brother, thank you so much. Okay, we got to figure out how we're going to get this kayak back in action. We gotta figure out how we're gonna get this kayak back in action. I know Beto just ordered some prongs. We needed them for the trolling motor on the skiffs and he found them right here. We have to clip the wiring, put a hole in the bow right here so that we can put our batteries below deck. But I need the same exact thing right here on the skiff. Hopefully the camera is going to get that. Can you get that, buddy? There we go. Right there, where those two holes are, they're supposed to be two male prongs, and they fell out. They just finally gave way, fell out, and I can't make contact with the battery wire. So we'll get that fixed, and we'll be back on the water in no time with the kayak. So that will do it for the day. Thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, don't forget to click that thumbs up button. And for those of y'all interested in all the gear that I used today, it will be linked in the description down below, so check it out. And if you make a purchase, just know that the channel will earn a small commission, so it also helps to support what it is that I do on a daily, and I definitely would appreciate it. That will do it. Until next time, tight lines, y'all.